darling, is here to present topic Nakshatra Vriksha and Sacred Roots, the traditional way for healthy and prosperous life. As we all know the quotation, Ekam Shastram Adhyanu Na Vidya Shastra Nishchayam, Tasmat Bhavishyata Shastram Vijaniyat Chikitsaka. I am here to present different references of the medicinal plant in other Shastras. Okay? As we all know that human relationship with plant is immemorial. We all are connected to plant both physically and spiritually from the beginning of life. We respect them and treated them as a god. There are references in our ancient sages like Namo Vrukshebhyo Eko Vruksho Dasaputra Samokave. In our ancient books like Tantraraj Tantra and Brihat Nigantu Ratnakar, there are references about Nakshatra Vruksha. What is a Nakshatra Vruksha? In ancient texts like Tantraraj Tantra and Brihat Nigantu Ratnakar, Nakshatra Vrukshas are mentioned. These are the plants allotted for a specific constellation. We all work on a specific constellation, and Nakshatra Vrukshas are plants for that specific constellation. These are divided into two parts. One is Aradhya and second one is Kshemkara Vruksha. What is the Aradhya Vruksha? Aradhya Vrukshas are the plants of your birth constellation, and these are the plants which are we have to do worship of them. And here, worship means taking care of the plant and connect yourself with the plant at the level of mind. And the cutting and hurting of that plant is prohibited here. Here is the next one, Kshemkara Vruksha. The Kshemkara Vruksha, first we know that in Atharva Jyotish, the fourth constellation from your birth constellation is given as a Kshem. Nakshatra Vruksha for this constellation is taken as a Kshemkara Vruksha. You can cut them and you can use in daily practice for your good health. There is a chart showing some Aradhya Vruksha and Kshemkara Vruksha. If you have the Ashwini Nakshatra as your birth constellation, you have the Karaska, that is Kuchala, Strychnos Vomica as your Aradhya Vruksha, and Jambu as your Kshemkara Vruksha. Fourth constellation is Rohini, and Jambu is the Aradhya Vruksha of Rohini. But Rohini is a Kshem constellation for Ashwini, therefore Jambu is a Kshemkara Vruksha for Ashwini. Next. Association, there is another references related association of planets and plants. You can see the Surya for Arakha, Chandra for Palash, and Mangal for Khadir, and Buddha for Apamarga. You know that about in Jyotish Shastra, Rahu and Ketu are the dragon's head and dragon tails are responsible for the mental properties, right? It affects on the mind. And Durva and Darva are the dravyas which are proven to be acted on the mind. Uses. Nakshatra Vruksha and the Kshemkara Vruksha have both physical and spiritual uses. The physical ones are the helpful in the diseases, especially for the specific constellation, and easily availability of the medicine in the day-to-day life. Spiritual, helpful in maintaining, making spiritually healthy mind, increase the stability and maturity of the mind by increasing inner power. As we know that the Darshan Shastra, there are the Tama. When the person is a tamasic, he has a tendency to destruction. But when you take a care of a plant, there you increase the sattva of the person, hence it increases the maturity of the mind and increases inner power. The next one is the traditional way, the sacred grove. What is the sacred grove? The sacred groves are the prowess fragments of varying sages, and communally protected, usually have significant religious connotation for the protected community. Hunting and logging are usually strictly prohibited. Patch of vegetation ranging from few trees to few hectares, which are left undisturbed. Here is some picture of sacred grove. The distribution of the sacred grove, it is all over distributed in all world, but related to the India, it is all distributed in all over India. And as it is denoted by various names, as in Karnataka it is a Devarkadu, whereas Maharashtra is a Devrai. Another in Madhya Pradesh is Saran. What is the importance of the sacred grove? Sacred grove, it has a medicinal value. It is proven in various research papers that Plants in a sacred root have more medicinal value also. The plants which are under threatened plant list also abundant in this sacred group. Macrofungi, which are great medicinal value, also abundant in the sacred group. It are the recharge of aquifers. Recharge of aquifers in the sense that where the sacred groups are mainly located in the place of a lake and something. And it recharges, means increases the oxygen level and this reduces the toxicity in the water. It also helpful in conservation of biodiversity and also act as a purifier of health. How it will make our mind and body healthy? It's simple question is there. It's natural attraction toward plants. We are connected to plants from beginning of life. Everyone likes to see plants with fresh leaves, flowers, than dry and hot deserts. Next slide is conclusion. Nakshatra Vruksha and Aradhya Vruksha play important role in making personal, spiritually and physically healthy. In all these, traditional concepts help human beings to live prosperous and healthy life. Concept of conservation of single plant from a single person makes easy to conserve it and also maintain the ratio between human and plants to keep earth green and healthy. The sacred group are playing a vital role in maintaining biodiversity, provide shelter, medicine and economical help when there is no other source for income. There is a law regarding sacred group in various other places. There are different laws. In some places it's strictly prohibited to cut and use of the plants, but in some other parts there is a committee related to it, and the committee takes decision about whether you have to use it or not. They allow for a particular material to take it from it. This traditional method hence play important role in healthy atmosphere for healthy mind. It's our duty as a person, rather a human being, to carry forward this heritage to our next generation, to make a smile on their face. Thank you. Thank you very much.